cool. Alright. Sorry guys, I ran out of batteries. It's just, it's Bush League here, so. Just trying to get this janky ass camera mount to work. Hey Mike, how you doing? Alright, let's do this. Alright, so... the rod journal on piston 2 looks really good. Like, very good. Looks perfect. So that's good. Very good. So let's keep taking this bad bitch apart. So this one looks good, this one looks bad. And I can show you guys the difference between the two. So the main difference is, this is how the connect, so here's the crankshaft, right, comes out of the engine. This is the connecting rod cap I just took off. Here's the piston connecting rod. So this is how it should look. It's like basically a mirror polish finish. It looks super good. And here's the one that's spun. And you can tell that it's like chunked up and scored and not good. So this is the second. We're going to take off that one and that one next and see how that does. We really want them all to look like this. The scored one, I think we can polish that out, but if they look that good on the rest, I think we're good. We can keep using that crankshaft. I think we could send it off to get polished. I'm going to measure the tolerances on it. Not tonight, but I'll measure the tolerances. That'll give us a good baseline for whether we can replace the crankshaft, or we'll just have to get a new one. Want to score the crankshaft, so I'm gonna put this on the back so I can pry it out in as gentle as a way I can. Right, I'm gonna twist. I'm gonna spin the block around a little bit. So you can see the piston's coming out here. I don't want it to fall on the ground, so I'm gonna try to do two things at once. Pry it out. And catch it. There it comes. All let's take a look at this. This is two, piston two. There is some vertical scoring on the skirt, but it doesn't look too bad. I can like just hardly feel it if I rub my fingernail across it. Yeah, there's some additional carbon buildup down here. You can see, like, over here it's really clean. Over here, not so much. Just, like, taking note of some of the things I see. This side of the skirt looks beautiful. I'm a little bit concerned of this burn mark. I'll have to talk to someone about how typical that is. I mean, this car was not running. It's not a boosted car, so. Yeah, here's the rod bearings. They actually look pretty good. No scoring. They actually look really good. There's some pitting. You can see two pit marks right here and here. That's a bit concerning. But I'm going to be replacing these anyways. I mean, this block did have a lot of fucking material in it. Like, you can see on my finger, it's like pretty gross. Yeah, on the other side, there's some pitting here too. Like up at the top. And then, like I was saying in the previous one, you can see the grain on the connecting rod where they break it off. So the cap only goes one way. And so you can, the grain from this one matches the grain on this one, so that when you put them together, they form like a really good solid seal. It's a little finicky because the rod bearings are getting in the way, but you can see how they should line up there. Dude, this light is really screwing up the... Yeah, there you go. You can see how they should fit together. Right. Those look pretty good. I'm going to label these as cylinder 2. let's move along and do, maybe we'll do, let's see, we'll do two. So I don't think there's going to be a good angle for a shot for this one. Switch. Thanks for hanging out with my ghetto ass basement. This room is like maybe like 15 by 6 or 7 feet. It's just filled with wheels and tires, mostly racing stuff, and like old furniture. Dead bodies, candy, all sorts of good stuff. I'm going to turn this so you guys can see it a little better. So I'm taking that one out. Loosen this, should help. There we go, popped it right off. Here's the next one. All right, what do we got here? So this one has some slight scoring. Can't really feel it with my finger, but it's really not bad at all. There's like one score line that goes down the middle of it. It's kind of like right. Let's see. Like right there, you can see a scoring line. That's from the bearing on the cylinder four. But no real pitting. There's like one pit right there. But otherwise it's pretty good. It's reassuring. 'Cause I mean, cylinder four rod bearing was pretty catastrophic, but it doesn't seem to have gone to the other ones too badly. All right, let's take out. I'm going to take that piston out. It's going to be this piston here. Bearing just fell out. It's not a huge deal. Comes. Ooh, yikes. Thank you. I gotta get the thing out of there. So this is where this tool comes in super handy. My little magnet on a stick. Thing's great. Everybody has to have one of these. It's like so invaluable. Okay. All right, so let's take a look first at the rod bearing. So the rod bearing doesn't look too bad. Feels good, smooth. Can't feel anything with my fingernail. There is some scoring. But it's pretty good, all things considered. Not a lot of pitting. The backside has me a little concerned though. Looks like the side against the connecting rod was moving around a lot. So that's interesting. But now let's look at the concerns I have with the piston itself and the connecting rod. So, skirt looks pretty good. But there's a lot of fucking bullshit material here. It's like not good stuff either. It's like connecting rod material. I don't like that. Otherwise it looks good. It's just dirty. It actually might be like this crud up here, this carbon buildup, but I don't want to risk it. Yeah, inside too, there's like bullshit in there, especially on the bottom side, like underneath here. I don't want to see that shit. Yikes. This is going to have a good cleaning. Good clean job. I'm going to have to take the whole thing. The wrist pin out and everything. But then if you look at the bottom of the crank, or the connecting rod. There's no scoring in here. It's just... Looks like the bearing was like dancing around inside. Kind of strange. I'm gonna take the other ones off and compare those two. this is all kinds of crunchy bullshit. Oh, that's nice. You know, it's kind of meditative doing this kind of thing on a Wednesday night. It's just me in my basement. The kids asleep. We'll do the first. Good thing I went to the gym today. Yeah, I like their hardware. It's nice. Hey guys. Nice to see some of y'all. Recognize a lot of people watching the feed. Nick. Alex, hey, you're there. 223, I see you too. Hope to see you drifting next year at Lock City or wherever Nedco's going to be. directly at Tom's new track. The cap on cylinder one looks pretty good. Hey Nick, welcome back. Cylinder one looks pretty good. No complaints. Yeah, you see, like, once I take the rod bearing out, there's kind of like marks underneath. I'm not sure if that's normal or not. I haven't seen a lot of these, so I can't say. I'm no, like, expert. But that's not like a running surface. The bearing itself is, and that looks good, so. Let's get that piston out. I'm coming out here. Pretty clean. Hey Marcus. Hey Mom. How you doing? Alright, so here's piston number one. Looks pretty good. See some more carbon here between the rings. I wouldn't say is bad necessarily, but not quite as healthy as like this side over here. Good side. Not so good side. Underneath. And it's like, there's still a bunch of material down here I wouldn't like to see in a good engine, but this is a spun rod bearing engine, so. All right, so on to the bearing. Yeah, there's like a heats. Oh, that's just oil. Okay. Yeah, it doesn't look too bad. Actually, looks pretty good. There's like one score right in the middle. Like a scoring line right in the middle, but I'd say it looks pretty good. No concern there, but I'm going to replace these rod bearings for sure anyways. Ooh, this one's cool. I think I should do one video where I show the differences between the EJ and the FA20 connecting rods, but here's a brief summary. One, if you can tell, the connecting rod is asymmetrical, so it's longer on this side than it is on this side. And then it's a crack connecting rod, so they actually cast or forge it as one piece. And then they just crack the top off. So the seam here and here, it's basically a crack that fits back, and they can only fit one way, and that makes the cap for every connecting rod works only with that connecting rod. They're not interchangeable in the FA series. The EJ, you know, EJ20, like the EJ207, EJ205, they were just separate pieces and they were interchangeable. Although you probably wouldn't want to do that, but here you can see the crack is actually pretty jagged. It fits back together like perfectly. So that's pretty. It's a pretty nice feature. So that was the goal for tonight, was really just taking the pistons out. Maybe tomorrow I'll do the rings. But I do intend to keep all these pistons. They're all seemingly good. I'm going to clean them up and reuse them. I may replace this rod. Because it is pretty scored. So I guess what I can show you guys now, I can show you the the difference with the crankshaft rod journals. Show you that first, and then maybe call it a night. All right, so here's cylinder one. Here's the crankshaft, goes all the way through. Cylinder one. It's like a basically like a mirror polish finish. If I rotate this into view, cylinder two looks really good. Mirror polish finish. Cylinder three also mirror polish finish. It's just oil. Now if we go down to cylinder four, that one doesn't look so good. This is the one with the spun rod bearing. Not a mirror polish finish. You can just see the difference between this one and that one. It's quite visible. Bad? Good. Let me just clean these rod journals with my wife's workout towel. Bad. Good. So what did we learn tonight? We learned that was fucked. That these are good. And I'm going to bring this crankshaft to my machine shop. So we can polish that and see if it's salvageable. And we took all these out. Cool. Alright, so the next step, maybe in a few days or maybe tomorrow, I'll get to work on cracking the block open and trying to get the crankshaft out. So that's the next step. Cool. Alright, thanks for joining me, folks. I will probably see you maybe tomorrow, maybe some other day. Bye.